This video is brought to you by Hoodbeast.com. Design your own custom hoodies. Hoodbeast.com.
Yo, what is up, guys? It's me, Zach Lee. And today we actually only got one topic to cover, so let's get right into it, I guess. He really thinks he's fooling someone. Kyrie Irving really thinks he's slick. I see through you, all right, Kyrie? I see clear through you. These eyes see everything. All right, so I gotta talk about this man, Kyrie Irving, for a second, and what he did that I found to be pretty interesting. All right, so yesterday, he came out and made it clear that he is not willing to commit long-term to any team that trades for him. Meaning that just because he gets traded to a team doesn't mean he'll commit to stay with them after 2019 when he's a free agent. And if you're a team that was looking to trade for Kyrie Irving, those are the last words that you wanted to hear. Since the Cavs have such a high asking price for him, Kyrie Irving basically just shot the Cavs and the other knee that he didn't already shoot them in when he asked to be traded in the first place. Because now the Cleveland Cavaliers won't be able to get nearly as much in return for Kyrie Irving as they would like. Before, if a team could trade for him with any type of reassurance he'd be willing to stay, they'd be willing to give up what the Cavs were asking for in return for Kyrie Irving. Now though that he's unwilling to commit to any team, teams will want to give up nearly as much for him. Sure, if they did trade for him, they still have two guaranteed years of Kyrie Irving, but come on, teams are more far-sighted than that. They don't want to give up too much for a two-year rental. That's almost never a good idea to do. Anyways, before this news came out, the Cavs had a certain asking price. They were looking for young players plus draft picks so they could build going forward. They know the position they're in and they want a huge return for Kyrie Irving. I saw an article that said they'd love to get Devin Booker for Kyrie Irving. And I thought that was one of the dumbest things I had ever seen. That's like a no-duh type statement. Of course they want Devin Booker for Kyrie Irving. I mean, who wouldn't at this point? That's like the Knicks coming out and saying, we'd love if we can get Andrew Wiggins for Carmelo Anthony. Of course you would. But anyways, the return that the Cavs could get for Kyrie Irving now will probably be just a bit better than what the Pacers got for Paul George, since it's not too different of a situation. Paul George let Indiana know that he wouldn't be coming back, so they traded him and he was a one-year rental. Kyrie Irving let the Cavs know that he wants to be traded. If they don't trade him, obviously he's not coming back after 2 years, so he's like a two-year rental. So yeah, the Cavs realistically can expect just a bit more than what the Pacers got for Paul George for Kyrie Irving. Now you might be sitting there asking yourself, why did Kyrie Irving come out and say this right now? Why would he purposely lower his trade value like this? And I think I have a pretty good idea why Mr. Irving did this. You remember when the news first broke about him demanding a trade from the Cleveland Cavaliers? Besides that, the other thing that came out that were 100% facts were the four teams that Kyrie Irving requested to be traded to: the Miami Heat, the New York Knicks, the Minnesota Timberwolves, and the San Antonio Spurs. Those are the teams that Irving wants to play for. Problem was, is that it wasn't up to him where he gets traded to. He doesn't have a no-trade clause like Carmelo Anthony where he can manipulate the situation. He can't just say, I want to go here, and the Cavs had to trade him there. The Cavs were going to trade him to whatever team gave them the most in return. Doesn't matter if it was Miami or Brooklyn. Whoever gives them the most gets Kyrie Irving. Out of the four teams that Kyrie Irving mentioned, really only one team was seem to have what it might be able to take to get Kyrie Irving in the Minnesota Timberwolves. And that would have been a package of Andrew Wiggins plus Jeff Teague, something along those lines for Kyrie Irving. However, there has been a plot twist to that, as Minnesota has came out and said that they're not willing to trade Andrew Wiggins in any package for Kyrie Irving. To them, Andrew Wiggins is as good as untouchable. So that kind of puts Minnesota out of the running to get Kyrie Irving. And then the other team out of the four that had the slightest chance would have been the New York Knicks. Some type of Melo for Kyrie Irving trade. That was still seen as a long shot, but something that Cleveland could do if everything else fell through. However, now that isn't even possible, as Carmelo Anthony said he is no longer willing to waive his no trade clause for Cleveland after this Kyrie Irving story came out. So New York isn't an option anymore either. So after all of that happened, Kyrie Irving saw that none of the four teams that he wanted to be traded to would be able to trade for him. And I think that's what caused him to put phase two of his plan into action. He now knows that if he still wants to get traded to one of the four teams that he wants to get traded to, he kind of has to level the playing field a bit for those teams. Since a bunch of other teams in the NBA, almost every other team in the NBA will be able to make better offers than the Spurs, Heat, Knicks, or Wolves. So the only thing Kyrie Irving can do in this situation is shoot his trade value down so all the other teams will kind of back off. Does that make sense to you guys? Since the teams he wanted to play for couldn't make big enough offers like other teams were doing, he had to somehow decrease the level of the offers that other teams were making for him. Basically, what Kyrie Irving said when he said he wouldn't commit is this: I already made it known the four teams I want to play for. So if any of the other teams in the NBA are crazy enough to trade for me, or crazy enough to give up a huge package in return for me, then by all means, go ahead. But just remember that that's on you. Because once I am a free agent in 2019, I am dipping to one of the four teams that I mentioned. I didn't want to be here in the first place. Which was actually a genius move on the part of Kyrie Irving, if you think about it. The Cavs more than likely are still going to have to trade Kyrie Irving. Like I said in the previous video, there is such a big divide between the whole city of Cleveland and Kyrie Irving at this point that they can't bring him back next year. They can't even start training camp with him at this point. You can't bring him back and just act like none of this ever happened. And by coming out and saying he's not going to commit, he's already lowered his trade value by so much that if you keep waiting, if you're Cleveland, if you do somehow go into the season with Kyrie Irving and you wait longer and longer and longer, his trade value is only going to diminish more and more and more, since teams will have less guaranteed time with Kyrie Irving, to the point where you do get pretty much the exact same package that the Pacers got in exchange for Paul George, if not even less. The genius behind Irving is he knew all of this. He knew what the Cavs were asking for from teams that wanted to be traded for him before he came out and said he's not committing to anyone. And he knew that teams he wanted to be traded for couldn't offer up what the Cavs were asking for. So in order to make it easier for those teams to trade for him, he just had to lower his trade value. Right now, I'd say Irving is more working out a sign and trade with one of the teams that he wants to play for more than anything. I mean, the Cavs have lost almost all control of the situation at this point. That is, unless some NBA team out there didn't get the message and still offers some ridiculous package in return for Kyrie Irving when he could just walk away in a couple of years and most likely will just walk away in a couple of years. And I don't even think Kyrie's done here. If he hears word that that might happen, that some team is about to make a serious offer for him, you could probably bank on him coming out again and decreasing his trade value even more to scare off that team. Like I said, Irving, you smart. You real smart, but you ain't sneaky. I saw right through you. I know the game that you're playing, and I might know the game, but unfortunately for the Cavs, it doesn't matter what game you're playing because, like I said, he is pretty much in control now. Irving already shot out both of Cleveland's knees at this point, and if he has to, I wouldn't doubt that he will pull the trigger again. But that's going to lead us to the question of the day. Is that what you think Kyrie Irving is doing? Do you think he's trying to manipulate the situation, lower his trade value so that the teams he wants to get traded to can trade for him? Let me know down in the comment section below, but now let's take a look at what you guys said in yesterday's video. And yesterday, after we talked about Porzingis adding muscle, I asked you guys if you thought that would help, and I also talked about that GoFundMe for LaVar Ball's teeth and what you would do if you were a dentist and saw those. And here's what you guys said. Question of the day: I think his muscle will help him play better D and outplay bigger players, and will help him run faster on the break. Question of the day: look, Porzingis' game operates strongly around being more agile and versatile than most athletic big men. Getting muscle can't hurt as long as that doesn't tamper with its quickness and explosiveness. If I was a dentist and I walked in to see LaVar's teeth, I would immediately walk back out. I'd do that and probably give up on being a dentist as a whole if I went in and saw the tragedy that is LaVar Ball's teeth. But yeah, seriously, the muscle that Porzingis has put on so far this summer will of course help him. It'll only make it easier for him to bang with the other stronger big man down in the post, and that of course will help him become even better. Like always though, don't forget to leave your answer for today's question of the day down in the comment section below. But other than that, thank you once again for watching the video. Hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more daily NBA videos. And until tomorrow, keep getting the Bucks, Team SEC, and I'm out of here. Peace.